गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ पीयूष माथुर फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग, आर्या कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड आईटी, खूकस, जयपुर। माई वीडियो लेक्चर इज बेस्ड ऑन सब्जेक्ट यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल पावर। इन प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर वी हैड स्टडीड अबाउट द इलेक्ट्रिकल वेल्डिंग एंड सम टाइप्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल वेल्डिंग। नाउ इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर we are going to some more types of electrical welding. First of all, electrical arc welding. Electrical arc welding, it means that process of joining two metallic piece or melting of metal is obtained due to the heat developed by an arc struck between an electrode and the metal to be welded or between the two electrode. In this diagram, this is the welding machine which take the power AC or DC power sources and controls, and the output of this machine, one point is connected to the electrode holder and other point is connected to a work table. This is called work table, and metal piece on the work table, and electrode is connected to the electrode to the work. In this process, an electric arc is produced by bringing two conductors, it means that electrode or metal plate connected to a suitable source of electric current, momentarily in contact and then separated by a small gap. So then arc glow due to ionization and give intense heat. The heat is so developed is utilized to the melt the point of workpiece and filler metal, and thus slowly their melt. In this method, the weld generally the no pressure is mechanical pressure is applied, so there is a this welding is also known as non-pressure welding. Now, factor required for length of arc. The surface coating and the type of electrodes used, the position of welding, the amount of current used. When the supply is given across the conductor separated by some distance apart, the air gap present between the two conductors and get ionized. As the arc welding is in progress, the ionization of the arc path and its surrounding area increase. In this method, the temperature of the arc should be maintained 3500 degrees Celsius. At this temperature, mechanical pressure for melting is not required because this is non-pressure welding. Both AC and DC supply can be used for the arc welding. Generally, usually 70 to 100 volt on AC supply and 50 to 60 volt on DC supply system is sufficient to struck the arc in the air gap between the electrodes. Once arc is struck, generally 20 to 30 volt is only required to maintain it. Now, types of electrical arc welding. The types of electrical arc welding are carbon arc welding, metal arc welding, atomic hydrogen arc welding, inert gas metal arc welding, and submerged arc welding. In this video lecture, we are study on two types, generally carbon arc welding and metal arc welding, and further methods atomic hydrogen arc, inert gas metal arc, submerged arc in next video lecture. Now, first of all, carbon arc welding. Carbon arc welding, it is the one of process of the welding in which the arc is struck between two carbon electrodes. So there is the supply system, DC supply system is connected to electrode holder, and electrode holder is connected with the clamp and electrodes, and these are the base metal, it means there is workpiece. And this the supply terminal is other supply terminal is connected to directly base metal. In the carbon arc welding, carbon or graphite rod generally used as an electrode. Electrode are placed in electrode holder, use a negative anode negative electrode and the base metal as a positive electrode. This connection is shown in this diagram. The negative electrode is connected directly to the electrode holder and positive electrode is directly connected to base metals. Generally DC is preferred for carbon arc welding. So there is no fixed polarity to maintain in case of AC. So we can easily use for the DC supply to the carbon arc welding. Heat the metal to the melting temperature on the negative electrode is 3200 degrees Celsius and the positive electrode is 3900 degrees Celsius. For the good utilization of the electrode, generally electrode used generally diameter 2.5 centimeter diameter we are huge, and with the rating current is about 500 to 800 ampere generally. Now advantage of carbon arc welding: the heat developed during the welding can be easily controlled by adjusting the length of arc. It is quite clean, simple and less expensive when compared to the other welding process. Easily adaptable for automation, both the ferrous and non-ferrous metal can be welded in this welding system. Now, drawbacks of carbon arc welding. Input current required in this welding for the workpiece rises its temperature to the melting oblique welding. We know that the temperature range is 3900 degrees Celsius and 3200 degrees Celsius. So we have required very high input current. So temperature is generally approximately double the metal arc welding. In case of the ferrous metal, there is a chance of disintegrating the carbon at high temperature and transfer to the weld, which causes harder weld deposit and brittlement. A separate filler rod has to be used if any filler metal is required. Now, application of carbon arc welding. It can be employed for the welding of stainless steel with thinner gauge, useful for the welding of thin high-grade nickel alloy and galvanized sheet using copper silicon manganese alloy filler metal. These are the application of carbon arc welding. Now, metal arc welding. Metal arc welding means the electrode used must be of same metal. In this metal, the arc welding, the electrode used must be the same metal as that of the workpiece to be welded. These welding are called metal arc welding. The electrode itself from the filler metal, an electric arc is struck by bringing the electrode connected to a suitable source of electric current momentarily in contact within the workpiece to be welded and withdraw apart. So in this diagram we show this is the we given the supply. There is a positive supply or negative supply if we given DC, and there if we given AC supply, there is a phase and there is a neutral. Then neutral is connected to base metal and phase is connected to directly electrode holder, and electrode is connected to electrode holder and connected is electrode holder momentarily. And these are the when we start the supply, these are arc is produced in this metal, and the generally the arc is struck bringing the electrode connected to a suitable source of electric current. So there are the welded and withdraw apart with the help of flux coated metal electrode. So this is a very simple method. In this method, the arc produced between the workpiece and electrodes result high temperature, the order of about 2400 degrees Celsius at negative metal electrode and 2600 degrees Celsius at positive base metal or workpiece. In this method, a very good utilization for the both types of supply we can use both AC and DC can be used for metal arc welding. The voltage required for DC metals, the arc welding is generally about 50 to 60 welding. For the AC metal arc welding is 80 to 90 welding. But the main disadvantage in this type of welding, the DC metal arc welding is the presence of arc flow. Therefore, the distortion of arc stream from the intended path due to the magnetic forces of non-uniform magnetic field with the AC arc flow is considerably reduced. So this is the main disadvantage when we use the DC metal arc welding. The presence of arc flow is distortion of arc stream due to the given the path due to the magnetic force and non-uniform magnetic field. So AC considerably is useless. Thank you.